Hello everyone, welcome back to ATP Creative Corner. In today's video, I'll be making this multi-purpose pouch which you can use to keep your cosmetics, skincare products, medicines, etc. Since this pouch is going to be the basics to all the bags that I'll be making in future, I thought I'll explain each and every step as to why it is done that way. So let's get started. Here I've taken my old jeans as main fabric. We need two pieces of the main fabric whose length is 12 inches and width is 10 inches. Two pieces of the lining fabric of same dimension, 12 inches across 10 inches. And a zipper of 12 inches in length. To begin with, I'm going to keep the main fabric whose right side is facing upwards like this. I'm going to keep the zipper with right sides facing downwards like this. Then I'm going to keep the lining fabric with its right sides facing downwards like this. I'm using sewing clips to keep all these three pieces in place. Now I'll give a straight stitch with 1 cm seam allowance. At the end of step 1, this is how it is going to look like. Here you can see that the zipper is sandwiched between the main fabric and the lining fabric. So that is how we want the final pouch to be, with the right side of the main fabric facing outwards and the zipper facing upwards. And when I open the zipper, we want the right side of the lining to be seen. In step 2, I am going to give top stitch here. Let's see, why do we need to top stitch? Now this is how top stitch looks like from outside. This is how it looks from inside. Without the top stitch, the lining fabric actually might get in the way of your runner, and sometimes it gets stuck inside your runner too. And it gives a nice finished look to your pouch. I've given the top stitch here. Now I'll repeat both the steps for the second piece of the main fabric. So I've kept the right side of the main fabric upwards. I'm keeping the right side of the zipper downwards like this. On top of this, I'm going to keep the lining fabric with its right side facing downwards like this. I'm using sewing clips to keep all these three in place like this. Now I'll give a straight stitch with 1 cm seam allowance. Now it's done. Now I'll give top stitch on this side as well. Next, let's move on to step 3. Here I'm using sewing clips to keep the seams one on top of the other like this. Now on the lining fabric, I'm marking two points which are 2 inches apart like this. Now I'll start stitching from this point and stitch along this line until I reach this point, leaving this space unstitched. Next, in the step 4, I'm going to spread one of these corners like this. and mark a point 2 inch from the corner and draw a straight line like this. I'll give a straight stitch along this line. Similarly, I'll do it on the other side of the main fabric. Now I'll do the same procedure on the lining fabric as well. Doing the previous step actually ensures a wide space at the bottom of your pouch like this. It gives a nice shape to the pouch. You can see a rectangular base here. Once it's done, it'll look something like this. Now, I'll trim off the excess fabric like this on all the four corners. Now, in the step 5, I'm going to turn the right side of the fabric outwards through this 2-inch space on the lining fabric. By doing this, all the raw edges of the main fabric as well as the lining fabric will be invisible from outside. Now, I'm going to seal this 2-inch space with a straight stitch. And now it's done. I'm going to push the lining fabric inside the pouch like this. Now, to decorate the pouch, I've made a 2-layered fabric flower from the lining fabric. I've already made a video on how you can make this fabric flower. I'll give the link in the description box below. I'm using fabric glue to stick this on to the pouch. So I use this pouch to keep my skincare products. These are the similar pouches I made using old jeans 2 to 3 years ago. And I use this on a daily basis. This pouch looks a bit different, but it's actually the same. I've only reduced the base and the height of the pouch. So I hope this video was helpful for all the beginners. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more videos. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.